If you ask me, machine empires are one of the coolest and most unique empire types in the game, and playing them can feel like a totally different experience to any other kind of empire. Today, we're going to go over exactly how to play as a machine empire, from creating your own custom empire to controlling them in-game. Like any empire type, when creating your own machine empire, you have a range of choices for what exact playstyle you want to go for. While they do have their set government type, which comes with a range of effects, they can still build for a range of different playstyles, just like any other empire. If you want to be a trading powerhouse, a fearsome warmonger, or a tall, condensed empire, you can do it all, just with a little machine twist. Baseline, you're looking at less war exhaustion gain, since you're an empire of machines, so who really cares about wars, increased influence, and harder encryption, since, you know, they're robots. Your leaders are all immortal and will only die if killed in combat, or very rarely from malfunctions. Pops must be built instead of reproducing, and you can't really do anything organics can, like psionics. Plus, you have to dispose of organics in your empire through one of three options. Aside from this, the galaxy is your oyster. It all really starts with the civics, since that kind of dictates their playstyle and approach to certain situations. You mostly have a list of similar civics to non-machine empires, just with their own machine-based twist. Today, to spice things up, I'm going to go for a determined exterminator and warbot, so my focus is going to be on exterminating every organic I come across and aggressively expanding as quickly as possible. The traits, again, are a similar list to non-machine empires but have their machine-based twists. I'm going to go with Uncanny for a relatively low impact 3 points, and then grab learning algorithms for the best leaders I can get as fast as possible, and mass-produced for rapid population of the expanding empire. As for origins, you're a little bit limited since a lot of them require you to not be a Gestalt consciousness, but there are a few to choose from, but the classic is of course resource consolidation to start your own machine world, perfect for your machine empire. That being said, just because my empire isn't like other empires, we're going to go with Slingshot to the Stars for that quantum carpal later on to get us deep into hostile lands to take them down from within. Finally, we can pick our ruler and their traits. Of course, we're going to go with an admiral, since all we do is war, 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 no matter what. Hostility on my leader, I can never have enough. Whenever your faction is doing damage, all of their stats go up, and we're ready to play. By the way, if you want this empire without copying it step by step, you can find a link to the TXT file in the description, which can copy into your custom empires list in your documents. Of course, pretty much every game of Stellaris starts out exactly the same, with exploration and building up your empire using anything you can get your hands on early on. Whilst doing this, we want to focus on military pretty much as soon as possible to get some powerful fleets on the go and make any early wars in our favor as much as possible. Of course, take the standard must-pick text to increase research speed, but instead of focusing on infrastructure when nothing else essential pops up, go for military to improve ships as much as you can. You'll also have a number of leaders to level up once you load in, and we're going to focus on military where possible, and the same for the council. Speaking of which, machine empire councils work a little bit differently. Instead of a collection of council members like organics, you have one faction leader and several nodes, which focus on different areas of your empire. It's essentially the same thing where you level up different nodes and actually saves you having to pick and choose leaders for the council and waste their skill slots with council skills. So again, pick stuff to help you with military like defense platform engineering, logistic programming, etc, etc. Aside from that, anything you get to increase leader XP gain will be clutch for even more skills to push your empire to the max. As for what agendas to go for first, after Infinite Opportunities has popped, I'd wait until you've picked up your first tradition, which is going to be Discovery for increased survey speed. For future traditions, I'd suggest Supremacy as the obvious one, everything related to the Navy and Warfare to make it larger and more powerful, so what's not to love? You can, however, save this one for later once you're actually going to war, since you don't really get much value out of it until then. You can go Expansion, since you are focusing on mass expansion. This will help your planets get rolling a little bit faster, as well as keep your empire size a little bit more under control. The pop assembly speed is what we're really looking for here, as it'll make our population and therefore planet production skyrocket. There's Aptitude, which will make your leaders even better with all kinds of bonuses, including increased navy size per admiral and general level. As for Ascension perks, Transcendent Learning is great for more leaders and faster XP gain, which is of course great with how much we're trying to optimize for combat. Imperial Prerogative is great for keeping your empire size down, plus you need two before you can get to the rest of the good ones. Machine Worlds, since your pops will do amazing work on them. Galactic Force Projection is great for all the capacity increases. And of course, if you really want to embody the Exterminator, why not go whole hog and become the Crisis? Once you have Discovery, start Chart the Unknown for even more surveying speed. We want to open up the map as much as possible for mass expansion to fund some big boy armies. Speaking of funds, other than the obvious allies, you're going to struggle with Unity. So be sure to build plenty of uplink nodes and maybe even have a planet focused entirely on Unity later on down the line to keep it coming, since those traditions and ascension perks will come in very useful later. The Finding the Voice agenda will be another good pick to help with this, but those percentage-based increases need a baseline to increase, so make sure to invest early to make sure you don't fall behind. Once you come across other empires, you'll have a choice of aggression immediately or distancing yourself from them. I would advise distancing to get started, since you'll be pretty weak unless you got really lucky with technology. Just take the regular precautions of building defensive star bases around entrances to your empire and continue expansion until you're good and ready to take them out. Expansion should be relatively easy, since you'll want to focus on allies' production anyway and won't be spending influence anywhere else, so can funnel all your resources into claiming as much territory as possible. Add on top of this that machine empires can colonize almost any planet, and you should get on a roll of planets and systems pretty quickly and have plenty of resources coming in before you know it. You do have to make sure that you stay on top of energy, however, even more so than usual. Machine empires don't require any food for their pops and instead consume energy for their sustenance. This of course means you don't have to waste any time making food, but it does mean you're going to need to compensate with a shedload of energy production. Now, if you get a planet that has lots of slots for agricultural districts, you can of course grow some food and either sell it on the galactic markets or build bioreactors to produce energy in exchange for food. Whatever you do, just make sure that you have loads of energy coming in, since you are going to need it, even more so than usual. Machine empires can also make use of robo-modding, which is basically the same thing as species modification, but using the machine traits. Of course, to change your current pops, you'll need tons of research, but if you build a pop assembly buildings, which you always should on every new planet, you can choose to only build your preferred species type to force them to spread through your empire a little bit faster. Do the usual strat, filling up your army with corvettes whenever you have spare alloys, and you should have a full army in no time. If you can spy how powerful enemy stations are, then you can judge when you're ready to attack, but I would advise preparing for the worst and waiting until you can challenge a fully defended home station before starting a war you might not be able to win. Plus, you have to remember that they probably have an army similar to your own waiting for you, so you'll need a lot of power to take anyone out early on. If you can hold off until you have some larger later game ships, it'll make taking out heavily defended star bases a lot easier. With this empire that's so set on wiping out all organics, you're going to struggle to make any friends, so just be cautious not to get into too many wars in one go, as you can still be easily overwhelmed until you get extremely far ahead. Overall, machine empires, including this one, are fairly slow to get started, since your production for things like Unity is pretty slow. But once you get into the mid game and have a few larger planets, you'll be able to produce pretty much anything you want on a massive scale. As long as all your resources are in the green, I'd focus on research where possible to rocket yourself ahead with science to fuel your military conquest as much as possible. As long as you keep expanding and wiping out organics in whatever way you see fit, you should be having a great time and be on your way to becoming a galactic threat in no time. Overall, machine empires offer a great alternate playstyle, since they ignore a number of things that organic empires tend to get involved in and have a more singular focus to their games. They're not drastically different by any means, but all those subtle changes add up to an empire type that really does feel like a big group of space robots, and personally, I think they're one of my favorite empire types to hop on and play around with. And that's just about all I have to say on machine empires. Any questions you have, leave them in the comments below. Like, subscribe, and if you want more Stellaris content, then check out this video to see my tier list for every single piece of DLC.